you. Now I'm here. Now I'm here. Think I'll stay. Think I'll stay. Round, 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 round. Oh yeah.
Comme promis ce soir, un reportage exclusif sur Queen, réalisé lors de leur dernier passage à Bruxelles. Queen est à présent le groupe de variété le plus populaire en Belgique et il accumule les disques d'or. Dans le film, il y a pas mal d'acteurs. Il y a l'accordeur de piano, le promoteur du concert, le chef des techniciens, le responsable de la table de mixage, les gorilles du groupe et puis le public, dont vous étiez peut-être. En tout, une super production avec 8623 acteurs et figurants.
This one's a little difficult, so I'll take this one.
Queen est une compagnie, hein? Ouais, qui c'est pas uniquement les quatre gens qui sont sur scène. Il y a peut-être 20 qui sont payés dans l'équipe de Queen sur une base de toute une année, même s'ils travaillent pas ou même s'ils sont en studio. Alors si Queen, par exemple, décide de faire la tournée en Europe, on est contacté d'abord pour disponibilité des salles, etc. Alors eux, de leur côté, ils font leur planning parce que bon, on peut pas faire, par exemple, lundi Berlin, mardi Bruxelles. Jeudi Copenhague, ils font une planning sur toute une tournée et ensuite ils font une sorte de préparation dans le sens que tout est établi ce qu'ils veulent comme point de vue lumière, hein, Et ce sont des compagnies différentes qui travaillent dans toute la structure de Queen. Queen fait appel à une compagnie pour organiser tout ce qui concerne les voyages, les tickets d'avion, les hôtels, etc. Queen fait appel à une compagnie qui fournit un road crew qui est bien connu ici dans toutes les salles en Europe. Queen fait appel à une autre compagnie qui fait les lumières, hein, et c'est une compagnie, par exemple, les lumières, c'est TFA Electro Sound, et c'est une compagnie de Los Angeles. Alors, Queen fait appel à des compagnies sur même les petits points concernant nourriture des musiciens, nourriture des techniciens, etc. Et vous voyez, comme on a vu tantôt, toute une cuisine est installée dans une des loges.
Sur les deux concerts, il va y avoir combien de monde?
Entre 16 000 et 17 000 personnes.
Queen était venu en 78 et ils avaient joué trois concerts à Front National. Et là, c'était encore plus de monde ou...
Sur les trois concerts, on a fait 21 000 personnes. Ouais.
Pourquoi
disons,
que...
mais maintenant, on pouvait faire encore deux jours aussi parce que je viens juste de parler avec les directions de forêt. Ils pensent qu'ils avaient pu encore faire deux jours en surplus.
Tellement il y a eu de demandes pour les tickets.
Oui, il n'y a plus de tickets à Bruxelles à partir du début de la semaine. Et selon Forêt, ici, la demande est si énorme qu'on pouvait encore faire deux jours.
Et pourquoi est-ce que ça n'a pas été possible?
Parce qu'il n'y a plus de dates disponibles. On est un peu limité. Si Queen doit suivre toutes les demandes, il doit faire 600 concerts sur une année et on n'a que 365 jours. Fait beaucoup de stress, ça veut dire qu'ils aiment bien d'avoir des hôtels qui sont de première classe, que les voitures, les limos sont prêts quand ils arrivent à l'aéroport, parce qu'ils ne voient que ça en tournée, hein. Ce sont les aéroports, ce sont les hôtels, ce sont les salles et les intérieurs des limousines.
Combien de temps as-tu passé à la préparation des deux concerts de Queen?
Disons que c'est assez simple, Queen. Hein? De certaine manière, avec Queen, j'ai moins de travail parfois que pour un concert à l'ancienne Belgique. Tout le monde ici a une responsabilité, il le fait tout à fait. Dans l'équipe de Queen, hein, il y a un agent de voyage qui règle tout concernant les hôtels. Bon, moi je fais les petits points du contrat. So come and get me.
In advance, we usually spend about 8 weeks of, you know, office preparation and this kind of thing. I've had physical work, but you know, we might be talking and booking equipment and that kind of stuff maybe 3 months in advance, 4 months in advance.
You created the light show with Queen?
Yes, with Queen and the lighting director. We discussed what will work and what won't work, you know. It's a lot of materials involved, you know.
How long does it take on the day of the show to put on all the material?
When it's supported from the roof like this, from 8 o'clock in the morning till about 5 o'clock in the evening. And if it's ground supported, you know, by towers, then it takes from about midnight the night before to go in. If we have to build a system that holds it up, you know, from the floor.
How many roadies do you need?
There's 17 plus truck drivers, and et cetera, et cetera. Probably a total of about 25 people.
With who have you worked before?
Oh, many different people. Elton John, Three Dog Night, Jimi Hendrix, and many different tours.
So you've seen all the evolution of the technical equipment?
Yeah, yes. I've been doing it since 1966.
Don't you think that the groups are going too far in the big equipment, big lights?
Not really. I mean, it all depends. The audience seem to like it. I guess, you know, it's possible. I mean, it's... I don't know. I don't think they're going too far, you know. It's the audience seem to like it. It's a show. It's a big production, you know.
When did it change, really?
The change probably came around, I guess, about 72, when the show started to grow bigger and bigger, I guess. It was about 1972.
Compared to other groups, how do you qualify Queen's equipment?
It's a large production. Yeah, it's about as many lights as you could put up in one day, you know, and do a concert somewhere else the next day, you know.
During all your career, you've worked with Jimi Hendrix and a lot of people. Who did you prefer?
None, really. They're just, you know, I enjoy working with most people. You know, I don't think you can say one person is better than the others.
Jimi Hendrix must have been a great experience.
It was a great experience, yeah. Was at the time you didn't realize what a great experience it was, but, you know, because it was just doing shows, but yeah, it was quite an experience.
And with Queen?
With Queen, yeah, it's quite an experience.
Thank you.
imagine. You want to rock them. You want to roll out. Okay, let's do it. Go.
The live show is the lifeblood of what we do in many ways. Because you spend, I mean, we're probably one of the few groups in the world at the moment who spend a lot of time recording and touring. And we try and put an equal emphasis on the two.
Yeah.
So we spend anything up to 3 months making one album, which everybody thinks is a long time. But we then come out and get down there and just play the stuff to our audience. And that's the time when we get the feedback, I suppose. So it's always a kind of exciting time when you just finished an album project and you go out and take it on the road and put the new songs on stage and see what people think of them. And we're very lucky in that people tend to understand what we do. And we don't feel that we have to adapt ourselves to the audience. We feel that people understand what we want to do as musicians. So we're in a fortunate position in that way.
It's a song called Fat Bottom Girls.
I feel like every album since A Night at the Opera has repeats the same schemes.
Really? Oh, what are you saying?
I don't agree.
No, I don't agree. I would say Day at the Races does and was meant to. News of the World, our last album, I think it's very different, totally different to both of those.
Yeah, News of the World was a complete reversal, really, because we got more and more complex up to A Night at the Opera and A Day at the Races, which were kind of twin albums, we felt. And at that point, we felt we had to go back and kind of start again with the very simple things. And News of the World is really very straight rock album. You know, there's almost no extra overdubbing, you know. And on this album, we've sort of changed again, and we're trying out some new directions, we feel. I don't see at all that they're similar.
No, we don't. We never consciously try to repeat.
It's a strobe, which lights up a disc which has a lot of stripes on it. And when you're exactly in tune, the strobe works in such a way that, it appears to be stationary. So that's a little flat, because the things are moving this way, and that's a little sharp. So if it's in tune, they stay like that. Very useful device, because you can do it with noise around. Guitars, and it's a problem with the people also, because you get hot and you sweat, and then you come off and it's really cold, and you get cold in the head or something, you know. And to perform nearly every night, you need to be very physically on top, I think. You have to be very, very fit. If you go a little bit underneath and you're on the tour, that's it, you know. everything's a problem. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's like being an athlete or something. You have to be physically right.
Keep in touch with today's rock scene, like the new groups?
As much as we can. We're not in our native country very much these days. We're generally either touring or recording, and we do both of those things outside England now, so we're probably less in touch with Britain than we were. But we listen as much as we can to the new people, yeah.
Is there any group you like?
I thought you were going to ask that.
Go on, name a few.
Like, oh yeah, I could name a few. Like, Devo or Talking Heads?
Yeah. Oh yes, so yeah. Two good ones.
Kraftwerk?
No, not for me. No.
Public Image?
No, the album is terrible.
Yeah?
Yeah, terrible album. Very disappointed.
Yeah, concerning punk, 2 years ago, the new wave exploded. Did you feel threatened by new wave at the moment or never?
Hard question.
Very difficult to say. We're aware of it, you know, but I think one must always be aware in this sort of industry, and we know what's going on, but to be frightened of it, that's the wrong word, I think.
Yeah, it was never really commercially successful. It just wasn't. I mean, there are probably two or three big albums, and now two or three groups have come out of that. The good stuff has sort of lasted, or tended to.
It made us out to be the bad guys as well, which is one way probably good, because it gave us more publicity, because we were meant to be bad, therefore they could happen, because, I mean, we're into all this.
But it seems to die now, you know, just the few bands.
Yeah. In the end, it's the talent that remains.
Take me
on a dream is born.
Many punk musicians say hard things about groups, superstar groups like you are.
Yeah, but they're very inexperienced. It's very hard to say these things when you haven't played that many shows, you know.
It's called jealousy.
Especially in a big...
But that happens all the time. I mean, when we started, we were jealous of... Who were we jealous of? Led Zeppelin.
Were we?
Yeah.
No, we wanted to be there. It's sort of goal that you want to reach, you know, and then...
Yeah.
It's all healthy. Yeah,
I think it's really talking about a fashion. It was a fashion at the time. Yeah. And it was a useful vehicle for people to make a noise, you know, if you say we're very much against what is going on at the moment. And I mean, in my opinion, most of what actually happened in the punk thing was a reversal, going back to what the kind of thing which we had developed from, you know. I think it's more of a fashion than an actual musical development, I would say. Had no luck at all. Nothing came easy to him. Now it was time. He made up his mind. This could be my last chance.
Sometimes you've been badly treated by the rock press.
Very badly back home.
Abused.
They don't like us, we don't like them.
A lot of people spend their time making up good things to say to the press and don't go out and work. They don't play rock and roll. They just do interviews most of the time and make a few records. But we just tour and record and work. You know, quite a lot. In fact, we're
allowed.
Wonderful people.
I'm not cold sober. Baby left me for somebody new. I don't want to talk about it. Want to forget about it. wanna be intoxicated with that special brew.